name is Margaret Harper Abdullah. I'm the head of centre at Glen Family Centre in East Renfrewshire. I work in a service for children and families under three, and our service supports early intervention and prevention and supporting our families in the community to build capacity. Staff support children through a knowledge of knowing the children really very well. So the staff have intimate knowledge of all the children that stay within the centre for lunch and for snacks. So we're aware of any dietary issues that a child has, or any allergies or any types of requirements that are individual to that child. But throughout the course of the lunchtime experience, the Swedish lunch experience, then children sit up at the same level as the adults, so that the communication is as good as it can be. The children have access to the adult. The adult supports sensitively through children being able to serve themselves around their lunches. There's discussion about what is for lunch that day, and what they would like, how much they would like in their plates, and what types of foods they like. And so children are absolutely included and involved in every decision that's made around that experience for them. That actually, you know, it's about the child, and it's about them being confident and building the skills around social interactions through meal times and nutrition. PDSA cycle was something that we used really effectively within the centre. So we had a service redesign, moving away from sort of a setting for children 0 to 5 to a setting for children under 3. So that gave us a really good opportunity to reflect on what we were doing with young children, particularly around our meal times. And we felt very strongly that we wanted to do something just a wee bit different. We wanted it to be a very nurturing experience for children. We wanted them to have control around that. We wanted them to be able to understand the rhythms of their day, and that, you know, lunchtime was a nice, relaxed, intimate time that they could enjoy with adults. So the way that we went about that was to do a small test of change first of all, and that was kind of looking outwards and looking at other partners that had perhaps embarked on that. And we had one of our local nurseries within the authority that had already made steps around Swedish lunches, so that involved some of the team going and observing how that setting was doing lunches, observing the children, speaking to the parents around that to see what the benefits parents felt the children were getting from it, speaking to the staff team around that, and then bringing it back to our own setting and speaking to our parents. You know, we're looking at doing something different around lunches. How would that feel? How do you see that sort of impacting for your child? Do you think that's an experience that they would enjoy? And we did a small test of change initially, just using one of the tables at lunchtime and trying to do that a wee bit differently. And very early on, it became really apparent that the children really were enjoying the experience, the staff were enjoying the experience. It was about taking time, it was about listening to children, it was about sharing that really lovely time with them, away from the busyness of the day, and listening to children, listening to what they're saying. You know, what would you like for lunch? Well, tell me what you would like. Let's do this together. Like, you know, you can be involved in that. Family involvement is really important at Glen Family Centre, and again we try to do this in partnership with our parents. And so the benefits that the children get within the setting, obviously we want that to extend out into the home, and we try to do that in a variety of ways. We're looking to invite our parents in on a rota basis to see the progress that the children are making within the setting during Swedish lunches, and for parents to see the capabilities that their child has. I think sometimes parents miss that, but actually our very young children under 3 can serve themselves, they can use cutlery, they can pour their milk, they can make decisions and choices and be independent in that. So it's really important for us to share that with parents. And also within the centre, we do have a member of our team who's trained in healthy cooking, and she undertakes cook clubs with the parents, and we offer that out to all parents whilst we kind of look at targeting maybe parents that are particularly struggling around nutrition and around income, and being able to do that in a budget and to do that well. That's something that would be offered out as a universal sort of approach for parents. And that has worked really well, and we see our parents growing in confidence. We see them building relationships with other parents. We see them having good fun and laughing and just enjoying that experience. And then being more confident about going home and trying things out, you know, trying to cook from scratch, trying to use ingredients that actually are not any more expensive really than maybe the fast food that perhaps is being bought sometimes as well. So for herself, it's a journey for everybody. It's for our children and for our families, but also for our staff team as well. So we continue to just develop in those areas and to move forward and try and extend experiences that we offer around our nutrition.